Hello and welcome to the Henry Cabot Lodge Fieldhouse in Beverly, Massachusetts, where the 3-4 Beverly Panthers host the 5-2 Georgetown Royals. I am Alex Luco for the BevCam Sports Network, and thank you for tuning in tonight. If you got in here early, you just saw the end of the JV game. Unfortunately, the Panthers could not pull out a win there. It was close going into the fourth quarter, but eventually Georgetown ran away with it. We are a little behind schedule because of that, so we will be sending to some commercials, and we'll be back just before the opening tip to see the starting lineups. We'll see when we get there.
You are watching BevCam. Here, anyone can come to the studio to make their own local TV show. Contact us with your idea. We'll help you get started with producing your own show, editing it, and then we'll broadcast it to all of Beverly for your friends and family to see. You might even get some new fans. We also film local events like sports, music, city council meetings, and more. If you miss out on anything in town, you can catch up on it here. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Contact us at 978-927-5544 or email us at admin@bevcam.org.
Got a quarter?
Most party fouls are pretty dumb. But if you decide to drink and drive underage, you could lose your license and your freedom. Underage drinking and driving, the ultimate party foul.
Everything starts out small. The things that hurt us, they all start from somewhere. The words we say, the things we do, they can grow into something else. What was small and innocent can become big and sometimes scary. All it takes is one comment, one picture, one video for something to catch fire. But a big problem doesn't need a big response. Not at first. Even if we don't know what to say, the eye emoji can be that first step we take. Let's all pledge to take that first small step together and change the world in a big way. I'm a witness, and so are you.
Everybody has a dream. Mine was to see the ocean. And with a little help, I made it.
The
they told me a bottle couldn't dream. That I would never become a superhero. But I learned how to fly. Just to come back in a new disguise. And be the hero that I've always wanted to be.
Listen.
All it took was someone who would insist that I just try.
Suddenly, everything was turned around because they judge you.
You tell them, I don't need this.
No one is going to understand.
Unless they've been through it, how can they?
Then one day you realize...
You feel so hopeless.
I need help. I need help.
You feel so hopeless.
Then one day you realize...
Unless they've been through it, how can they understand?
I don't need this.
No one's going to judge you.
Suddenly everything was turned around because they insist that I just try.
All it took was someone who would just...
Listen.
And welcome back to the Henry Cavill Lodge Fieldhouse here in Beverly, Massachusetts, where once again, the Beverly Panthers will host the Georgetown Royals. I'm Alex Lucco for the BevCam Sports Network. Thank you for joining us. Beverly coming in off of a loss to Masco at home. That was on Friday where they lost 46-29. Junior Lauren Cayley led the team in scoring with 9 points. She added 5 rebounds as well. Maddie Young right behind her with 5 points and 4 rebounds. And Emma Mueller, sophomore forward, adding 4 points and 4 rebounds herself. They come in and they face a tough test in this Georgetown team, winners of 3 straight, and they can put points on the board. So the question is, can Coach D'Angelo and this Beverly offense go toe-to-toe with a high-powered, potent offense that Georgetown can provide? I guess we're going to find out here. We're about a minute and a half away from starting lineups in the national anthem. Georgetown is also 5-2 overall coming into this game, 3-1 in the Cape Ann League. They lead the Baker division in the Cape Ann League. And Beverly, although they are 3-4 on the year, they are 3-1 in the NEC thanks to 2 crucial wins against Danvers right at the end of the year and then the beginning of 2023, most recently at home where they took a 42-38 win into the Masco game. In that game, Aracola led the way with 12 points. She took away 4 balls from the other team and added 2 assists. Michaud came in off the bench, 7 points, 3 steals, 3 rebounds. And Olivier, who I was very impressed with in that Danvers game, 6 points and 6 rebounds for her. She leads this team in rebounding, 7 rebounds per game for the Panthers. Close to starting lineups here. The crowd is a little bigger here tonight at the Fieldhouse. It is Youth Night, where the basketball community around Beverly is really coming together in the Fieldhouse to root on this varsity girls team. Sure, there are plenty of young student athletes all in this crowd playing off to the side on the court that hope to one day play on this court. See the boys team there in the stands. They have a big game against Lawrence here tonight, or excuse me, here tomorrow night. There's the boys team there, Dylan Crowley right in the middle. Ryder Frost a little bit to his right. And we should be ready for the starting lineups momentarily. Starting for Georgetown is going to be Tyra Marcelin, Megan Lowen, Marley Morrison, Alyssa Zalkowski, and Katie Davies. 2 freshmen in that lineup was Zalkowski and Davies, a couple of seniors in Lowen and Morrison, and Marcelin, the lone junior in the starting lineup. For the Panthers, it will be Bilotti, Kaylee Griffin, Olivier, and Aracola. And we will pause for the national anthem. Or we won't. We'll have some updates for you later in the broadcast about the Beverly High School Hall of Fame, adding another class after a few years on hiatus due to COVID-19. If you ask me, I think our producer, Robert Doakes, needs to be in the next class, but we'll see. It'll be Kaylee and Davies taking the tip. Kaylee wins it. Griffin tracks it down. Beverly with the first possession. Aricola looking to get going early. Good defense up top, provided by Marcelin. It's Griffin. Bilotti drives baseline, kicks it back out. Kaylee with the pump fake. Bilotti, Olivier. 10 seconds on the shot clock. She'll drive right with some contact. She'll be called for the charge, I believe. Georgetown, their first possession. They get it into the corner. Driving baseline and up. A little bit of contact there. That was Alyssa Zalkowski. And I believe Bilotti is going to be called for the foul there. I believe that was actually on. Nope, that was on Bilotti. Freshman Zalkowski gets the first one to go. And knocks them both down. First points of the game come from the free throw line. 7:15 left to play in the first quarter, and Georgetown is pressuring early on in this game. Bilotti doing a good job of getting it past half court. Looks for Aricola, the team's leading scorer, with just a tick over 8 points per game, and we'll get a foul on junior Tyra Marcelin, her first, in the first team foul for Georgetown. Bilotti looking for Griffin. Gets it to Kaylee up top. Aricola for three. Just off the mark, rebound Georgetown. Coming away with it was Megan Lowen. They're pushing in a nice deflection by Griffin just past midcourt to slow down the Georgetown attack. Marcelin looking for the corner. Deflected, but eventually corralled by Zalkowski. Gets back to her in the middle of the floor. She'll kick it back out to Marcelin. 10 on the shot clock now. A three. Zalkowski, can she get it? She can. The freshman already with 5 points. All five so far in this game with 6:10 left to play in the first. Kaylee, baseline. Left hand, no good. Coming away with the rebound is Kaylee, however. Gets it out to Griffin, takes a three. Got it. Griffin with the first points for the Panthers tonight cuts the lead down to two. Another three from Georgetown. Off the back rim, rebounded by Aricola. She chased it down, and now she's pushing the Panthers. Griffin with it again, fakes the shot, down to Olivier. Trying to kick it back out, has it deflected. Down to the ground, deflected again. And Georgetown comes away with it. Marcelin now driving on Kaylee. Gets to the rack. Puts it up. No good. Rebound Aricola. And we might have a jump ball. And we do. Possession stays with Georgetown. But the arrow moves. Couple of substitutions. Ella Thompson and Nyla Marcelin see their first minutes in today's game. Zalkowski again, corner. Just off the mark. Olivier with the rebound. Seems like Beverly's going to have to keep an eye on Zalkowski from beyond the arc. She's already let a few fly. She has a good form. And I'm sure a few more of those are going to fall in tonight. Heads up play there by Griffin. Deflected by Georgetown. Lets that one go out of bounds. I believe that was our camera operator, Tim Hizzy, over there. Tim Hizzy over with the assist for the referee. Kaylee couldn't get it to go, but there's a foul on Katie Davies, second team foul for Georgetown, and Kaylee will head to the line to try to tie this at five with 5 minutes left in the first quarter. Kaylee knocks down the first. She led the team in scoring on Friday in that home loss to Masco with nine. Gets them both to go. Kaylee also added five rebounds in that game as well. Long pass to Zalkowski, I think deflected by Ericola, but also by Zalkowski. And they're looking for her in that corner. That might be her sweet spot, and a great job by the Beverly defense to swarm at the point of attack. Georgetown keeping this pressure on. Griffin easily gets past half court. She drives, kicks it over to Kaylee, back out. Bellotti, long two. And that one's stuck. That's the second game in a row I've seen where this happens. And let's see who tries to be the hero. And it's going to be the Georgetown ref. Excuse me, Georgetown head coach. A lot smoother than the Danvers game, I would say. That will be Beverly possession. Beverly looking for their first lead of the game. Ericola. In and out. Olivier with the board. She gets fouled. She'll go to the line. That foul on number 14, Alyssa Zalkowski, her first third team foul for Georgetown. Olivier gives Beverly their first lead of the game. 6-5, 4:40 left to play in the first quarter. Good job to come away with points off that offensive rebound for the Panthers. And who else but Olivier, the team's leader in rebounding, as Georgetown answers back. Number 22, Nyla Marcelin, a freshman. Up and under. Lead back to Georgetown. The freshman Marcelin with her first bucket tonight. All 7 points for Georgetown, scored by freshman. Olivier, nice spin moving up, good. We've got a crowd tonight at the field house. Beverly takes the lead right back. Third lead change in a matter of a minute. Looking up top to Zalkowski. Guarded by Ericola. Switches to the left hand, has it deflected, and Bellotti comes away with it. Beverly doing a good job in the half-court defense. Not letting Georgetown get comfortable. Getting hands in the lanes. Forcing a couple turnovers early on. To try to turn them into some offense as they turn it over themselves. And Zalkowski with Olivier back in defense. Dishes it out, and there'll be a foul on Olivier, and I believe that will be number two. That was on her. Third team foul for the Panthers. And Abby Ruggieri, the senior forward, will come in for Oliveira after she picks up her second foul in the first quarter. Nyla Marcelin can't knock either free throw down, but Ruggieri, as she gets the rebound, steps out. They retain possession to the Royals. Lucky break for Georgetown here. They'll get another possession off the missed free throw attempts, and Marcelin will miss that attempt, but an offensive rebound and another foul, I believe this one on Griffin. That will send Megan Lowe into the line. Lowen knocks that one down. Bellotti coming out for the Panthers. Anna Michaud will enter in her place. And Lowen knocks them both down. The lead back to Georgetown, 9-8, 3:13 left in the first quarter. Ruggieri looking for somewhere to go with it. Almost has it turned over. Shirts on the floor, will get a jump ball, and the possession will stay with Beverly. And Georgetown continues the pressure in the first quarter. Hasn't really given them too many fits so far, but... And it looks like it's going to be with Georgetown. So I'm not sure what that was. I do believe Beverly had possession. And we're just going to call that a makeup call as a travel. Beverly will have possession now, but as I was saying, in that first quarter, the pressure really wasn't giving Beverly too many fits. They were easily getting the ball past half court, inbounding the ball, starting their sets, but that last possession really gave them fits, and so does this one as Aricola gets called for the travel, goes back to Georgetown. Marcelin kicks it out to her older sister, I presume. A three. Off the mark, rebound, Michaud. Beverly looking to get the ball past half court for the first time in about a minute, and they do. Aricola picks up her dribble. Ruggieri, drive right into the defense, have it deflected. Last touch by Ruggieri, back to Georgetown. Substitution for Georgetown as Lowen will exit. And freshman Bailey Pearson will enter in her place. This Georgetown team is full of freshmen and they're getting some minutes here so far, and I believe they will be for the rest of the game as some of their more impressive players have been freshmen. We'll get a foul on the Panthers. I believe that's going to be on Michaud. Michaud called for the hold, the 15 foul for the Panthers already. 2:22 left to go in the first. Two more fouls and Georgetown will be in the bonus. Strong defense from Kaylee. Georgetown looking to get it down low to Marcelin. Deflected, taken away by Ruggieri, and Griffin is having some trouble on her own keeping it, but she gets out of dodge and gets it past half court. Aricola there to slow it down now. Michaud, Ruggieri, thought about the three, gets it to Kaylee, looking for Griffin, ends up getting it to Aricola. She'll drive, kick it back out. Michaud, Kaylee, poked away. It will stay with the Panthers with 10 seconds left on the shot clock, and this Georgetown defense is picking up assignment after assignment, rotating, providing help defense. Beverly's having a hard time finding some open shots. Pick and roll, Ruggieri can't hang on to it, and that's about her third turnover in this first quarter in similar fashion. This Georgetown team has a pretty tight rotation. Subbing in a lot of bench players as Griffin comes away with the rebound. We have two more awaiting to get in. Seems to be a constant rotation in this first quarter for the Royals, trying to keep their team fresh. Griffin looking for somewhere to go with it. Michaud comes away with it. Out to Ruggieri. Fakes a shot, drives, has it poked away, but we'll get a foul this time, I believe, on number 11, Marley Morrison. That was on Morrison, her first. 14 foul for the Royals. Beverly keeps possession as Griffin will inbound. Nice dish and a quick shot by Kaylee with the left hand. She has four. Griffin with the assist on the out of bounds play. Stanchel drew up a pick to set her free on the left side of the basket, and that was an easy two to give Beverly the lead. Up and in, that's good. Lead back to Georgetown. Katie Davies, her first bucket of the game. Michaud, Kaylee thinking about a three. She'll pump, fake left, go right to Michaud. Michaud driving left with the left hand hook, can't get it to go. Rebound Davies, she'll keep it. Shot clock turned off, 17 seconds left on the clock. Marcelin with a deep three from another zip code. Off the mark, Griffin grabs the board. 11 seconds and count. Shot clock turned off. Beverly looking to reclaim the lead before the end of the half, and she'll be fouled. Believe that'll be on Ella Thompson. Both teams with five team fouls. With 5.5 seconds left to go in the first quarter. Griffin looking for somewhere to go with it. And a kick's gonna be called on Zawakowski. No time off the clock there. Deflected. We'll stay with the Panthers. Still 5.5 left on the clock. I believe they're going to roll the clock here, as that had to have taken at least a little bit of time. Then we're going to have it at 5 seconds flat. Big opportunity here for the Panthers, trying to go down low, and another kick. Four and a half now on the clock. Beverly can take the lead. Kaylee for three, blocked, rebound, put back off the mark, and the rebound was tied up underneath the hoop. So after one, Georgetown leading 11 to 10. Beverly finding open baskets has been difficult for them so far, but when they have, they've sunk them. Lauren Kaylee leads away with 4 points so far, and Griffin adds three with the first points of the game for the Panthers to cut the lead down to two early on in that first quarter. And Nyla Olivier with 3 points, but she's also on the bench with two fouls in that first quarter to add to the total of five for Beverly so far in that first quarter, but also Georgetown with five team fouls. So both teams very close to the bonus. This could be a long, grinded out kind of game. Who makes their free throws is going to win this game, as Georgetown's holding on to only a 1 point lead going into this second quarter. For the Royals, it's been really the freshman standing out. Alyssa Zawakowski with 5 points. Katie Davies with two, Nyla Marcelin with two, and also the senior Megan Lowen with 2 points at the line. No Georgetown player has more than one foul. It's evenly spread out, but as I did mention, Panthers have Nyla Olivier on the bench with two fouls, Michaud with one, Griffin and Bellotti with one as well, and the Panthers we'll send out there Michaud, Kaylee, Ericola, Griffin, and Ruggieri. even with some struggles in that first quarter, you'd have to think Coach Stanchel is happy with 10 points in the first quarter. This team averaging only a tick over 30 points per game so far on the season. So to get 10 on the board in the first quarter, I think really shows that this Beverly team is planning on sticking around with Georgetown for the entirety of this game. We have the refs talking to the clock operator. Seems to be some confusion here. It's on the possession arrow. And so the confusion was something that they got wrong earlier. And who would have thought that? Michaud, deep pass to Griffin. Trying to get it down low to Kaylee. Almost has it poked away. She puts it up. It's in for two. The junior with 6 points tonight to lead all scorers. Back and forth here at the Lodge. Zakowski for three again. Front iron. I believe last touch by Griffin. That'll stay with Georgetown. Georgetown in the corner, driving baseline, putting it up is Marcellin. Off the mark, offensive rebound, however. The hook shot won't go, and Beverly can't come away with the rebound, and there'll be another foul, the second on Michaud. And that's going to send Lowen to the line. Lowen knocks down the first. Michaud stays in the game with two fouls. 7:16 left in the first half. Lowen can't come away with the second, but an offensive rebound was let up, and there'll be a jump ball. Good job by Katie Davies avoiding the box out, and possession will stay with Georgetown because of the new quarter. That was Beverly's possession, and the arrow shifted. And again, it's now back to Beverly. Olivier comes in. Two fouls. She'll have to be careful not to get a third, as well as Michaud there on the defensive end. And that'll either be on her or Iracola. And that's going to be on Michaud. So three on Michaud, 17 foul on the Panthers. And Georgetown is in the bonus for the next 7 minutes and 9 seconds. Lowen 3 for 4 at the line tonight. Make that 3 for 5 as Bilotti comes in for Michaud after she picks up her third foul. And after making her first three of the evening, she misses her next three. Knotted here at 12 with 7 left to go. In the first half, Bilotti long two, off the mark, rebound Iracola. She'll try to put it up. Could have been a foul call, but no whistle, but Olivier is there to collect the offensive rebound. New shot clock for the Panthers, and it's turned over off the fingers of Iracola. Pass from Bilotti. Marcellin at half court, guarded by Griffin. Pick set. Marcellin almost loses it, but gets control of it in the corner again. Olivier, stout defense. She'll go up for help on Marcellin, just off the mark, and Olivier coming away with the rebound. Again, some great defense in rebounding from Olivier already in this first half to make a difference for the Panthers. Griffin loses it on the way up, but Iracola comes away with it. Stanchel, I think, lobbying for a foul call. Bilotti gets it to Iracola. Olivier picks up the dribble, looking for somewhere to go. Griffin, 5 seconds on the shot clock. She'll drive around a few defenders and be fouled on her way up. She'll shoot two. Ball's going to be on Megan Lowen, her first. sixth team foul for the Royals, and we're going to have some more substitutions shortly with the freshman Marshallin entering, as well as Ella Thompson. Griffin knocks it down. Lowen will take a seat, as well as Marley Morrison, as Beverly takes the lead again, 13-12. Make it 14-12, as Griffin now has five on the evening after knocking down both free throws. Marcelin driving right. The corner three. Off the mark, Griffin, right place, right time. Beverly looking to start strong off that defensive rebound, but slowed up by Georgetown. Olivier driving, a floater off the mark, out of bounds. Ball going the other way. Three from Marcelin, got it. The freshman continues to impress. She has five, and Georgetown now has the lead, 15-14. Griffin, a long two, I believe, was on the line. Tried to answer right back, but it's going the other way quickly. Marcelin to Marcelin, back to her sister, off the mark. Griffin keeps it alive for the Panthers, and we're all tied up. Arrow with Beverly, they have possession. Timeout from Georgetown. 4:59 left to go in the first half. Georgetown with a 15-14 lead. Four points so far in this second quarter for Georgetown. And four for Beverly. You see, when Olivier is on the floor for the Panthers, they play with a little bit more of an edge. I definitely think that was missing towards the end of that first quarter when she had to sit on the bench with two fouls, and Stanchel, able to get her back into the game here, is going to do wonders for this team. Georgetown definitely has a lot of shooters, so you have to guard the perimeter, but it seems like both Marshallin sisters can drive at will. They have great handles. They can get to the rack. I think Olivier is going to have to come up big on the defensive end, and she's shown it so far. Georgetown continuing the pressure, and this forces a turnover off the foot of Aricola. Inbound play up top to Marcelin. Spin move, floats it up there. No good. Aricola rebound. Beverly needs to get this past half court. Stop the swarming defense from Georgetown. Make them retreat. Griffin picks up the dribble. Down to Ruggieri. A little bit of a dream shake there. Shades of Akeem Olajuwon, but we're going to get a jump ball, and it'll stay with Georgetown. Go towards Georgetown. Marcelin using the pickoff. Bates driving. Zajkowski open for three, but we're going to have a timeout for an injured player. I believe that's Olivia Griffin. Looked to be grabbing her nose. Maybe bumped there. It was Bates that set the pick. And she'll take a quick breather as Maddie Young comes into the game, as well as Kaylee. And Ruggieri will exit. Zajkowski back to Bates. A three, but I believe tipped by Young. seems like no Beverly player was able to notice it, but she comes away with the steal. 2-on-2, driving left. We're going to get a foul on 13. It's on Ella Thompson. That's her second. And that'll be 1-and-1 from here on out for both teams until we get to the double bonus. Huge opportunity for the Panthers, who have had trouble finding open shots. If you can get to the line and knock them down, so you get your points at the end of this first half, as Young can't knock down the first, but a good bounce for the Panthers as she comes away with the offensive rebound. Kaylee. Young in the corner. Olivier looking for somewhere to go with it. Bilotti has it now. Olivier leading the way. Mid-range jumper, no good. Rebound Marcelin, and quickly off to the races are the Royals. And we're going to have a trip, I believe, on Aricola. Aricola's first, but the eighth team foul for the Panthers. Marcelin will be shooting 1-and-1. Marcelin knocks down the first, her first points of the game. Tyra, a junior. Believe it's her little sister. She's a freshman. She's got 5, but Marcelin now on the board with her first point of the evening. Good shot there, the two sisters. And knocks them both down. With the different jerseys, as my producer's pointing out. Some say Georgetown, some say Royals. I would say not enough funding. The classic for any area high school. Get these teams some cash. That's what I say. Bilotti fakes the three, gets it her bite. Long two, got it. Bilotti's on the board with 2, cuts the lead down to 1, 3:10 left in the first half. This has been a back and forth entertaining game between the Panthers and the Royals at the Lodge tonight. Offensive rebound, put back, no good. Aricola coming away with it. And I believe last touch by Georgetown, and it was. Georgetown's going to continue with the pressure. This has not made it any easier for the Panthers. Georgetown has turned over Beverly a few times doing this. More so in the second quarter than in the first. Kaylee, though, easily breaks that down the left sideline. Young, Bilotti, 3. No good, back to Georgetown. Substitution. Zakowski back into the game. Tied for the team lead with 5 points with Marcelin. Olivier guarding Zakowski on the perimeter. Up for 2, and it's good. Nayla Marcelin, 7 points lead, all scorers so far tonight. The lead back to 3 for Georgetown. Young to Bilotti, mid-range, just off the mark, but who else is there but Olivier puts it in for 2. 5 for her tonight, cuts the lead down to 1. Just under 2 left in this first half. And when we thought the second quarter would show a lot of foul shots, because both these teams were in foul trouble, and as I'm saying that, foul on Kaylee, we haven't seen many in this second quarter as we thought we would. It's Kaylee's first. Knocks that one down. 4-for-7 at the line tonight. That's where all of her points have come from as Griffin re-enters for Young after being shaken up a few moments ago. And Lowe knocks him down. All 5 points coming from the line for her, 5-for-8. 3-point lead again for the Royals as Beverly easily beats that press to Bellotti, down to Olivier. Griffin thought about the three, gets Marcelin flying, has it deflected, shirts on the floor, possession will stay with the Panthers. 23 left on the shot clock, 1:32 left in the first half. Olivier jockeying for position. Bellotti wide open in the corner. No good. Marcelin with the rebound, and she's off to the races already. Past half court. Ziakowski in the corner. Three off the mark. After that first make in the first quarter, she's been cold from beyond the arc so far as Bellotti's going to get called for a travel. And it'll stay with Georgetown. Ziakowski again in the corner. Deflected, Bellotti coming away with it. No pressure here from Georgetown. Aricola, Griffin, pump fake got her. Can't make the bunny, but Olivier is there with the offensive rebound, but she can't get it to go. Kaylee kicks it out to Aricola. Driving with the right hand in the lane, no good. Rebound Georgetown going the other way. So a few opportunities for the Panthers, had open looks. As a travel on Georgetown gives the ball back to the Panthers. As I was saying, the last possession for the Panthers, they had about 3 open looks at the basket. Griffin, Olivier, Aricola, no bucket to speak of, but Panthers catch a break as they get the ball back off of a travel from Georgetown. Griffin inbounding, gets it to Olivier. Has it deflected and out of bounds, last touched by Marcelin. Deflected by Ziakowski, looking for Bellotti. Beverly with another inbound, this time from just in front of the Georgetown bench. Marcelin really playing off ball, and we're going to get a foul on Ziakowski. That's the second on Ziakowski, and we're going to be shooting 1-1. It's the 8th team foul for Georgetown. Bellotti knocks down the first. Beverly substituting Ruggieri in for Olivier. I think that's smart. You don't want a third foul before halftime as Bellotti knocks them both down. The lead is back to 1. A 3, good. From Avery Upite, the sophomore, her first bucket. 4-point lead for the Royals now. Shot clock turned off, 26 and counting. Beverly trailing 24-20 at the end of the first half as Kaylee can't come away with that pass from Aricola. And Georgetown will have a chance to extend this lead before the half. Marcelin. Upite with the hook shot, got it to go. 5 quick points for the sophomore at the end of this first half as Georgetown has a 6-point lead and the clock's ticking. They're looking to add to it. Ruggieri in the way, but Ziakowski got it to go at the end of the first half. Beverly just squandered that away towards the end. They were down 21-20 with about 28 seconds left, and Georgetown fired off 7 quick points. First of a 3 from Upite, then a hook shot, and at the end a turnover off the inbound gave Marcelin her 8th and 9th points of the game. So at the end of the first half, Beverly trailing 28-20. They battled in that first half, as I said, They were only down one with 28 seconds left to go. But Georgetown forced some turnovers, hit some big shots, and they take an 8-point lead into halftime. Leading the way for Georgetown in that half was Marcelin with 9, 5 apiece from Lowen, Ziakowski, and Upite. 2 from Marcelin and 2 from Davies. On the Panthers' side, 6 points from Kaylee. She leads the Panthers. And 5 apiece from Olivia Griffin and Nyla Olivier. 4 from Maya Bellotti. And that'll do it for the first half at the Lodge. I'm Alex Luco. We'll be back momentarily after some PSAs and some commercials.
You are watching BevCam. Here, anyone can come to the studio to make their own local TV show. Contact us with your idea. We'll help you get started with producing your own show, editing it, and then we'll broadcast it to all of Beverly for your friends and family to see. You might even get some new fans. We also film local events like sports, music, city council meetings, and more. If you miss out on anything in town, you can catch up on it here. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Contact us at 978-927-5544 or email us at admin@bevcam.org.
Got a quarter?
Most party fouls are pretty dumb. But if you decide to drink and drive underage, you could lose your license and your freedom. Underage drinking and driving, the ultimate party foul.
Everything starts out small. The things that hurt us, they all start from somewhere. The words we say, the things we do, they can grow into something else. What was small and innocent can become big and sometimes scary. All it takes is one comment, one picture, one video for something to catch fire. But a big problem doesn't need a big response. Not at first. Even if we don't know what to say, the eye emoji can be that first step we take. Let's all pledge to take that first small step together and change the world in a big way. I'm a witness, and so are you.
Everybody has a dream. Mine was to see the ocean. And with a little help, I made it.
They told me a bottle couldn't dream. that I would never become a superhero. But I learned how to fly, just to come back in a new disguise and be the hero that I've always wanted to be.
Listen.
All it took was someone who would insist that I just try.
Suddenly, everything was turned around because they judge you.
You tell them, I don't need this.
No one is going to understand.
Unless they've been through it, how can they?
Then one day you realize...
You feel so hopeless.
I need help. I need help.
You feel so hopeless.
Then one day you realize...
Unless they've been through it, how can they understand?
I don't need this.
No one's going to judge you.
Suddenly everything was turned around because they insist that I just try.
All it took was someone who would just...
Listen.
Welcome back to the Henry Cabot Lodge Fieldhouse, or lovingly known as The Lodge. I'm Alex Lucco for the BetCam Sports Network. Beverly trailing after one half, 28-20, and it was much closer than that score suggests. With about 30 seconds left to go, Georgetown held a 21-20 lead, but fired off seven straight points, five coming from Avery Upite, the sophomore, one from a three, one from a hook shot. And just at the end of the first half, turnover off an inbound play was stolen by Nayla Marcelin, who put it in right at the buzzer. Excuse me, I don't believe that was Marcelin. I believe that was Zylkowski at the end of the first half. We'll have to check that. But if that is true, and I believe it is, Zylkowski with 7 points in that first half, Marcelin with seven herself, Lowen with five, all at the line. Two from Davies, five from Upite, and another two from Tyra Marcelin, the junior. On the Beverly side, Lauren Cayley with 6 points, five apiece from Griffin and Olivier, and four from Bellotti. We saw a lot of fouls in that first half. Anna Michaud on the bench with three, Olivier with two from the Panthers. And the only two players for Georgetown with two are Zylkowski and Ella Thompson. Play resumes here in the start of the second half. Marcelin looking for Zylkowski, but Ericola deflecting that with some good defense. Cayley guarding Zylkowski. She'll kick it out to Marcelin. Thought about a three. Goes to the left hand, kicks it back out. Davies almost loses it. Zylkowski open for three. No good. Rebound Olivier. And she'll throw that one away. It was Morrison providing pressure as Olivier ripped it away. The sail, and or the pass intended for Ericola, sailed over her head. And Georgetown quickly with another possession. Oh, three. Off the mark from Morrison. And Beverly will have possession now with 7:14 left in the third quarter. Georgetown still pressuring. Olivier still hasn't dribbled. Griffin past half court now. Kaylee up top. Bilotti now looking for Ericola. She gets it to her. Fakes the three, drives right, picks up her dribble, and a travel. So a couple of quick possessions for the Panthers and a couple of turnovers here to start this second half, and I'm sure that's not what Coach Stanchel really wanted. After a sloppy end of the first half, allowing seven straight from Georgetown. Down low. Nice defense by Bilotti. She'll come away with the block and the rebound by Kaylee as Griffin has control. Kaylee now to Griffin. Fakes the three, drives with the left hand, and I believe we're going to get a foul on the floor on Megan Lowe, and that's her second first team foul for Georgetown in this second half. Blotty in the corner. Griffin, free throw line. Looking for Olivier, gets it to her, back out to Bilotti. Good in and out ball movement. Couldn't get the open shot to go. Rebound Georgetown. And it's going the other way. Lowen, driving right. No good, offensive board and a putback. Count it. Lowen with points 6 and 7 so far tonight. Her first field goal, her other 5 points came from the free throw line. As Ericola gets past half court to a wide open Griffin, gets it to go. Beverly's on the board here in the second half. The lead back down to 8:30 to 22. 5:33 left in the third quarter. Ericola, defense on Ziakowski, stolen by Kaylee. Beverly trying to get something going now. They seem to have a bit of momentum, and if they can capitalize on this trip down the floor, this field house will be buzzing. Kaylee driving, open lane. Can't get the left-handed shot to go. Marcelin down low, deflected, kept in, but Lowen stepped out as she was trying to save it. Substitution for the Royals. The freshman Marcelin enters the game, as well as Ella Thompson. Thompson, one of three Royals with two fouls. Ericola breaks the press. Olivier goes up strong, can't get it to go. Rebound Marcelin. Her and her sister on a fast break. Driving in the lane, got it. Tyra for two. Georgetown's lead, the largest it's been tonight. It's up to 10 now, double digits, as we're going to get a foul on the floor. That'll go on Ella Thompson, her third. But with the way this Georgetown rotation has been shaking out, that should not affect any coaching changes or decisions, as we're going to get a double dribble from Ericola just before half court. This Beverly team has been in this game. They were in the thick of it in the first quarter, in the thick of it most of the second quarter, but it's sloppy play and turnovers like we're seeing in the first 4 minutes of this second half is what's Beverly's downfall so far. Kicked out, three, got it. Ella Thompson, her first points of the evening. And the lead's back to 13. It's all Royals so far tonight, like we're at a Lord concert. You see Coach Stanchel there, can't be happy. The first 4 minutes of this second half. Beverly being outscored 7-2 in the early stages, in the first half of this third quarter. Griffin, mid-range jumper, off the mark. Rebound, Michaud. She's just back into the game, and a hook shot, got it. Michaud's first bucket of the evening. Poking away at that Georgetown lead. Turnover. Back into the hands of the Panthers. Aricola looking for Kaylee. She gets it there. Quickly to Michaud, but a misguided pass as it's quickly stolen. Zawakowski, quick. Marcelin for three. In. Quick timeout from Stanchel. We saw that one coming. Marcelin now with 7 points to match her younger sister. We'll see who has bragging rights on that ride home. And for dinner this evening, as Georgetown takes a 14-point lead with 3 minutes and 20 seconds left in the third quarter. Beverly only scoring 4 points so far in the first four and change of this quarter. Georgetown already with 10. We said this Georgetown team can put up points. The only time they've really been out of a game so far this season was when they were playing Pentucket, and I'm pretty sure I could get my best group of friends together and that Pentucket girls team would beat us 10 times out of 10. It was 63-24, that Georgetown game at Pentucket. So if you're watching at home thinking that this Georgetown team has got some talent, they're pretty good. Just imagine that beatdown that Pentucket gave them, how good that program is year in and year out. And the Cape Ann League as a whole, especially on that girls' side. You know, the boys, their division is really lacking. You have Newburyport there up at the top, and they're just beating down on everybody. But that girls' side is just something to reckon with. Beverly now looking to get something going. Olivier up to Michaud, almost traveled. Keeps her dribble. Ruggieri has it blocked. And Marcelin going the other way. Zawakowski, another three for Georgetown. This one just off the mark as Griffin comes away with it. She has an open Ruggieri driving right with the contact, and she'll be shooting two at the line, trying to chop away at this Georgetown lead, which has gotten all the way up to 14, their largest of the night. Foul's going to be on Marley Morrison, her second. Third team foul for Georgetown. Beverly, no fouls so far in this quarter, as Ruggieri can't knock down the first. Pearson and Davies back in for Zawakowski and Morrison. And Ruggieri 0 for 2. That trip at the charity stripe. Michaud playing some tough defense. Aricola coming away with a steal, trying not to have a jump ball, and Griffin comes away out of the pile with the ball. Griffin past half court now. Down low to Olivier. Loses it on the way up. And these careless turnovers by the Panthers are piling up. With just over 2 minutes left to go in the third quarter, Marcelin dribbles around everybody, but Olivier is there to grab the board. Griffin, Ruggieri, long two after a pump fake, off the glass, banks open! Beverly pressuring. Gonna force a jump ball. And this crowd is electric here tonight. But possession will stay with Georgetown. And it's gonna be Beverly's ball, Look down for one moment and you get it all wrong. Aricola has that poked away, stolen into the hands of Lowe. Marceline to her younger sister. Driving around with contact, no good. Rebound, Beverly, and it's Olivier. Griffin has that one poked away. Michaud comes away with it. 4-on-3, Beverly has the numbers. Olivier driving, gets it to go. Beverly on a 4-0 run here. They've cut the lead down to just 10 now with just over a minute left to go in the third quarter, and their pressure seems to be causing some problems for Georgetown. Marceline drives right, has it poked away into the hands of Griffin. Aricola taking her time, getting it past half court. Has it poked away by Marceline, it'll stay with the Panthers. This Panthers team at times have really stayed with this Georgetown team. If not for the end of that first half, this game would be a lot closer. As Marceline pokes that one away, Griffin with the rebound, with the defense, and Marceline with a little nifty behind the back, but she could not get the layup to go. Going the other way again, Young just inserted into the game. Over to Ruggieri, fakes the three, drives, pops. Trying to go off glass again, but this time bank's closed. 15 seconds left, shot clock turned off. Marceline, charge! Olivia Griffin taking that charge for her team, and if Coach Tom Donovan was here, she'd be getting a Tommy point. That's the second on Tyra Marceline. Beverly getting that ball in, trying to cut the lead to single digits with 6 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Ruggieri, Griffin, deep three. Off the glass, no good. Rebound Georgetown. And that's the end of the quarter. Beverly, 28, Georgetown, 38. 8 points for the Panthers in that third quarter. 10 for Georgetown. And really, the difference in this game is the end of that first half. If you don't allow Georgetown to go on that 7-0 run, this is a much closer game, a 3-point game. Fouls do not seem to be an issue on either side. Georgetown only with 3 team fouls in that third quarter. Beverly with none, so they're sitting pretty in that regard. As for individual fouls, Beverly only 1 player with 3. That's Anna Michaud. Nyla Olivier, after getting too quickly in that first quarter, great job by her and her style of play, being aggressive, normally having to guard one of the better ball handlers and point scorers on the other side. No fouls from her after that first quarter. She's still at 2. A handful of players with 1. That's Bilotti, Kaylee, Griffin, and Aricola. And on the Georgetown side, a few players with 2. You have Tyra Marceline, Megan Lowen, Marley Morrison, and Alyssa Zalkowski. 1 player with 1 in Katie Davies and Ella Thompson with 3. But as I mentioned before, the way Georgetown uses their rotation, constantly subbing in players and subbing out players, that has not been an issue, and I do not foresee that being an issue. Zalkowski is a lone player with 3. Ruggieri deflecting that one. Georgetown in the corner now, driving baseline. Good defense by the Panthers and Griffin there, and Aricola coming away with the steal. Young looking baseline. trying to get it down to Ruggieri. She can't control it. We'll have a jump ball. It'll stay with the Panthers, but Georgetown earns that next jump ball possession. Griffin out to Aricola. Jumper from the charity stripe just off the back iron. Not enough touch. Quickly back is Griffin to stop any potential fast break. She does a good job, but Beverly needing to box out as Georgetown comes away with the offensive rebound. But Griffin, the smallest player on that court by far, comes away with the board. Ruggieri, little floater, no good. Offensive rebound, Griffin, back to Aricola, and she'll look to reset. Olivia Griffin has done a great job fighting for loose balls, grabbing rebounds where she has no business grabbing, as we'll have another jump ball, and Aricola slammed to the ground by Marceline. Possession over to Georgetown. .640 left to go. Georgetown still with a 10-point lead, not a bucket or point scored so far, as Young comes away with that steal and a foul. A roar from the Beverly bench on that hustle play from Madeline Young. And we'll have a foul on Marley Morrison. That's her third. Fourth team foul for Georgetown. Young. Back to Griffin. Michaud drives over to Young. She'll drive baseline, poked away. Stays with Beverly, 24 on the shot clock. Griffin has Young in the corner, gets it to her. Thinking about driving baseline, but Marceline has that great defense, has her trapped in the corner, kick ball. It'll stay with the Panthers. We'll have a new shot clock. Excuse me, no he won't. Shot clock is down to 23. Referee's talking with the scorekeeper. Michaud, quick shot. Ooh, couldn't get the and one, but she'll shoot two. Foul's gonna be the fourth on Marley Morrison. Morrison now one of the starters on this team, not a point tonight. As Michaud can't knock down the first. Morrison will exit with her fourth foul, and in will come Nayla Marcelin. The freshman, she has 7 points. Four Royals tied for the team lead with 7 points apiece. That's both Marcelin's, Ziolkowski, and Lowen. Georgetown gets it past half court. Davies thought about the shot and a foul on Griffin. That's her second. I do want to talk to you about the Beverly High School Hall of Fame. We will have new inductees this year for the first time in a few years because of COVID. We have Bill Poole Jr., an original member of the Beverly High School Hall of Fame committee. Coach Dan Bauer, who won Super Bowls with the Panthers, the football team, 2010 and 2012. That 2012 season, that team went 13-0 and is regarded locally as probably the best team in school history, as Lowen knocks that down from the line. You have Bill Foley Jr., a longtime soccer coach, two-time Salem News Coach of the Year, as Lowen knocks both down. Kevin Leahy, another soccer coach here at Beverly, two-time Salem News Coach of the Year as well. Paul Smith, cross-country stud and broke three records at the New England Championships in Vermont. In one meet, three records. Paul Doan, the first tennis player inducted into the Beverly High School Hall of Fame. William Shea for track, and he is one of four athletes that still hold the state record in shot put. I remember I ran track with his son, Josh. Brian Norris, third generation track Hall of Famer in his family, joining Bill and Bob. You have Jay Monroe, a multi-sport athlete. As Beverly can't get that one to go, but they will keep possession. Jay Monroe, a multi-sport athlete and Chick McLean trophy winner on the Thanksgiving Day game. Pat Bailey, who made me fall in love with Beverly Athletics. When I was younger, I remember seeing him play, one of the best running backs of all time at this school. I still think, as Misha knocks that one down, to add to her total, she now has four. In my opinion, Brendan Flaherty is the best running back in Beverly High School history, and I think the best athlete ever to grace the halls of this school. And you have Kelly O'Connor for cross country, swimming, and track. She was the 2009 BHS Student Athlete of the Year, and the team inductee is the 1973 cross country team. And as I said before, I do think our producer, Robert Doakes, should join that list. Why he's not in there already is beyond me. But you know what? He's a humble guy. Beverly down 10, 5.5 left to play in this fourth quarter. Even at 2 apiece in the fourth quarter alone. And now that Georgetown has this 10-point lead, they've been able to focus a little bit more on defense and pressure, taking risks. Because of that huge scoring run at the end of the first half that gave them this cushion, they can play a little aggressive. They can play a little loose. Beverly has to play perfect from this point out. No careless mistakes, no sloppy turnovers. It's going to come down to not only can they make their shots, but can they find open shots consistently? This Georgetown team has done a great job defensively of putting them into a box and not letting them breathe, really, for the majority of this game outside of that first quarter. Three from the corner. Good. Zylkowski knocks it down. She has 10 to lead all scorers, and you knew it was about a matter of time before she hit her second three after hitting one early in the game. Olivier, little floater, no good. Grabs her own board. The putback off the mark, trying to grab another one, but Georgetown will come away with it. That's Davies. Marcelin using a pick, drops it off to her sister. She'll drive, but she'll be called for a travel. .440 left to play. Griffin has it at half court. Drives left, picks up the dribble. Olivier at the free throw line on the ground, jump ball. Possession pointing to the Panthers. They will keep it. Ruggieri comes in for Olivier. Griffin down low to Aricola. She'll be fouled, and she'll go to the line to shoot two. Aricola held without a point so far tonight. The team's leading scorer with just over 8 points per game. Leads the team in three-pointers made, second in assists. Knocks down her first. Couple substitutions. Zylkowski and Morrison head to the bench. Zylkowski and Lowen head to the bench. Aricola can't knock down the second after making the first. And Griffin, playing great defense all game long, pokes that one away. Can't save it, but the effort is there. And Griffin comes away with it this time. Young driving with the left hand. Tries to kick it back out. Ruggieri gets it. Pass too long for Aricola, but who else is there but Griffin? Michaud now driving with the left hand. Has it blocked by Marcelin. But the rebound kicks all the way back out to Griffin. Shirts on the floor. Possession will go to Georgetown. and the Stanchel brothers looking for a foul call. Anything. Marcelin. Back to Morrison. Back to Marcelin in the corner. Can't get that to go. Rebound Ruggieri. Beverly, not much time left to mount the comeback. Down 12, 3:41 left in the fourth quarter. Has that one deflected by Marcelin and the freshman. She's been everywhere so far tonight. Young to Ericola, long two, off the front of the iron, rebound Ruggieri, she puts it up, she's in for two. Lead down to 10 now. Beverly gonna have a little bit of pressure after that made field goal, and I believe a foul on Young or Ericola. And no foul call, just out of bounds. Griffin with defense on the sideline forces a timeout from Georgetown with 3:13 left to play and a 10-point lead. Georgetown with only 5 points in just about 5 minutes of play in that fourth quarter so far. Beverly also with five. Coming out of this timeout, Coach Stanchel needs to see some aggressive play from his team. I'm sure that's what he's preaching. You're down 10 with 3:13 left to go. This isn't over yet. Force a couple turnovers, play a clean 3 minutes of basketball. And this could come down to the final shot if you play your cards right. Possession still with Georgetown. Ziolkowski inbounding. Looking to get it quickly back to her. Nope, they get it to Marcelin. Back up top, poked away by Young. At half court, she's driving left. She'll go up, have a little contact, no foul call, but Griffin's there to collect and miss the shot, but it will stay with the Panthers. Coach Stanchel, again, arguing for a foul call. In the second half, he seemed frustrated with these referees and these officials. Griffin inbound, looking down low to Young, and he'll get the foul call he so desperately wanted for the past quarter and a half as Young will shoot two. Young knocks down the first. Her first points of the evening. And two for two. Lead is down to eight now. Marcelin quickly past half court. Ziolkowski dialing up from three. Got it. She's got 13. Go along with three three-pointers. And we're back to an 11-point lead for Georgetown. Young, a three of her own. Got all three of them. Scored the last 5 points for the Panthers. 2.5 left, leads down to eight again. Marcelin dribbling through two Beverly defenders quite impressively. And Ericola is gonna be called for a foul. That's only her second, and only the fourth team foul for the Panthers. Ready? See on your screen there, Georgetown with 5. Beverly close to being in the 1-1. But the way they've shot free throws tonight, that's probably not the recipe to success, and neither is letting Alyssa Ziolkowski dial up from 3 again. That's her 4th. She's got 16 to lead all scorers. And I believe we're going to get a violation or a timeout, and it's going to go to Georgetown. Yep, we are going to get a violation, inbound violation. 2:07 left to go. Georgetown back up 11 and the ball underneath the hoop. Ziolkowski again, heat check. No good, rebound Michaud. We're going to get a foul on number 10, Megan Lowen. 6th team foul for Georgetown. Excuse me, nope, that looks like it's going to be 7. So we were wrong there, and we'll be 1-1 with 2:02 left to go. Michaud at the line. She's got 4 tonight. No good in the first, but Olivia Griffin with the offensive rebound. Beverly needs a bucket, and they need it quick. Young, she'll be fouled, or offensive foul on Michaud with an illegal screen. That's her 4th. The totals aren't really going to matter at this point. Down 11 with a minute 51 left. You need your best players on the court. Griffin with defense on Marcelin. Now Michaud will pick up number 5. And that'll be it for her. And Michaud will sit with her 5th foul. And Stanchel taking advantage of the timeout. Be able to talk with his team. Bilotti enters the game for Michaud after fouling out. Michaud added 4 points for the Panthers before her departure. Still an 11-point game. Marcelin Chilby tripped by Ruggieri. She's actually going to be called for a block. That's the 6th team foul for the Panthers, so one more, and Georgetown will be in the 1-1 as well. And they're calling this 1-1. I'm seeing 6 team fouls on the scoreboard, not 7. And now I'm seeing 7. So 2 quick fouls by the Panthers get Georgetown in the 1-1. And Tyra Marcelin knocks it down. She has 8. Can't knock down the 2nd as Aricola comes away with the rebound. Georgetown still pressing, up 12 with a minute and a half left. Griffin. Driving right, she gets fouled. She'll shoot 1-1. First foul on Nayla Marcelin. The 1st is good. And Griffin knocks them both down. Been effective all over tonight. Layups, free throws, and a 3-pointer in the 1st quarter to give Beverly their 1st points. Also played great defense as Ziolkowski will take another 3. This one no good. Griffin rebound. As Young will drive. Left hand, she'll be fouled by Marcelin and she'll shoot 2. Young with 5 points, all coming in this 4th quarter. Looking to add to it to maybe cut this lead down to 8. Young knocks down the second after missing the first. Beverly with some pressure. Only down nine, but only a minute six left. Zalkowski, another three. Good. I believe somebody came down hard. I didn't quite see what that was. Looks to be Tyra Marshall, and I look down to mark the three in my scorebook. And we have an injured player. Marshall and a starter on this team, 8 points tonight. Great ball handler. Seems to set the tone of this team, plays with an edge. Look to be looking at her right knee and Beverly training staff taking a look. Not only is this truly disappointing for her, but how do you feel as a sibling on the team as well? That Beverly trainer is Brittany Hoyt. You can see her as well as coaching staff. And freshman Alyssa Zalkowski. This doesn't look good. And we're going to cut away now to Beverly team. They're discussing it. And as the opponent, you're trying to mount the comeback down 12 with just over a minute left as the crowd gives an ovation for Marceline as she's helped to the bench, and you can only hope for the best. And after something very real as an injury like that happens, you still have to play this game. And if you're Beverly, you still have to try to come back. And if you're Georgetown, you still have to play with your back against the wall, because if you let your foot off the gas for just a second, this Beverly team could make it interesting. Bilotti to Griffin, Aricola for three. No good. Bilotti trying to come away with the rebound, but it's Davies who ends up doing it. 44 left on the shot clock, 44 left on the game clock. Marceline dribbling around every Beverly defender and coming away with her own rebound as another three is chucked up. That one off the mark, rebounded by Georgetown. Zalkowski back up top. And we're gonna get a foul on Bilotti. And Georgetown will be shooting 1-1. Morrison, she'll knock down the first. Her first points of the evening. Senior starter, she had four fouls and had to sit for the majority of this quarter, but she's back in and knocks two at the line to give Georgetown a 14-point lead again. Bilotti trying to get it down low to Ruggieri, and Griffin comes away with it. She has her shot attempt sent away, and that'll all but do it. Shot clock turned off, 16 seconds left in the game clock. All Georgetown has to do is dribble it out, and after an injury off of an unnecessary three-point shot to begin with, you would think they're not going to chance anything, keep the rest of their team healthy, and take a 55-41 victory as they leave the Henry Cabot Lodge Fieldhouse. Beverly putting up a fight, in that first quarter and in that first half for the most part until the last 30 seconds of that first half where Georgetown took that 7-0 run into halftime. It was going to be a one-point lead into the locker room. It turned into eight, and Beverly keeping it close throughout the whole second half but could never chisel away at that lead. If Beverly scored, Georgetown scored twice. If Beverly hit a three, Georgetown hit a three, got a steal, and took it in for two. It was never close, within about 5 or 6 points for the majority of that second half. I believe the smallest lead Georgetown had all second half was 8 points, and it hovered from 10 to 14 throughout the majority. So a good job by the Georgetown Royals getting that lead going into halftime and burying the Panthers for the second half. On that Georgetown side, it was Marcelin who we saw get injured, unfortunately, in that fourth quarter. She had 8 points, 9 points from Megan Lowen. Morrison added two, Ella Thompson added three, another two from Davies, five from Upite, all coming in that 7-0 run at the end of the first half. Nayla Marcelin, the freshman, she had seven, but it was really Alyssa Zalkowski in her three-point shooting. She led all scorers tonight with 19 points, four made three-point field goals, and the rest was history. On the Beverly side of things, scoring was quite even. Bilotti had six from Kaylee, seven from Griffin, six from Young, all coming in that fourth quarter. Olivier had seven to lead the team, four from Michaud and Ruggieri and Ericola. Only one lone point. The team's leading scorer, normally scoring 8 points, you can count on a big night from her, but her lone point came on a free throw in the fourth quarter, and Beverly will fall to Georgetown. So Beverly now dropping two straight. Their next game will be at Gloucester on the 13th, and then they'll go to Salem a few days later, and then the week after, a couple home games against Marblehead and Saugus. They're still 3-2 in the NEC even after that loss, but they look to improve as the weeks go on, as we head more into 2023. For everyone here at the BevCam Sports Network, excuse me, I have the names written down and I know your names, but I just need to remind myself. We have Chris Roy, Tim Hezzy, and Mike Pereno on the cameras. Always have to give them a shout out, the lifeblood of BevCam and everything that we do here. And a big thank you to Robert Doakes, our producer. I am Alex Saluko. We will see you tomorrow night. I believe Dom, Coach, and Rich Francis will have the call. Does coverage start at 6:30, Robert? 6:55 coverage starts at the Fieldhouse against Lawrence. A big game, must-see TV. We'll see you then.